In this exercise, we're going to explore the user interface of AutoCAD Civil 3D 2014. In question one of this exercise, we're asked to locate some commands just to become more familiar with navigating the user interface of Civil 3D. And specifically, we're asked to find commands on the ribbon. The first one is Match Properties, which, if you look, you'll find it on the Home tab of the ribbon here on the far right. Next is Import Survey Data. You'll also find that on the Home tab of the ribbon, as well as the Insert tab. Next is Add Labels, which you'll find on the Annotate tab of the ribbon. Next is the Inquiry tool, which you'll find on the Analyze tab here. Elevation Editor you'll find on the Modify tab. The Tool Space button you'll find on the Home tab. And finally, the Points from File, which you'll find on the Insert tab. For the second part of the exercise, we're asked to practice becoming more fluent within the Civil 3D interface by opening a drawing and trying out a few different parts of the user interface. The first one we're asked to try out is the application menu, and actually by opening the drawing itself, we're able to utilize the application menu. So I'll do that now. I'll go to the application menu, click the open command, and browse to user interface 2 and open that up. So I've used the application menu to access the open command. Next, for letter B, we're asked to use the command line. So I'll just click on the command line down here and type a command in this case the line command, press enter, and that launches the line command and starts the prompts, the first prompt being to specify the first point. And I could draw a series of lines by executing that command. Next is to utilize the ribbon. So lots of different things we can do on the ribbon. For this example, we'll use the Tool Space button to control the visibility of the tool space in the user interface. Next, we're asked to use Prospector. So while we have Tool Space open, I'm going to use the Zoom To feature in Prospector to locate the Side Road B alignment. So I'll right-click Side Road B, pick Zoom To, and you can see that the drawing has zoomed into that alignment. Next, we're asked to use some transparent commands. So let's go back to that line command. I'll launch that from the command line, pick a starting point, and then I'm going to go over to my transparent commands toolbar and say that I want to do a line by bearing and distance. I'll pick the northeast quadrant, enter a bearing of 45 and a distance of 250, and I've just drawn a line by bearing and distance. Then finally, we're asked to use the Inquiry tool. That's on the Analyze tab of the ribbon. I'll open the Inquiry tool. Actually, it's already open here on the right. And I want to use the Surface Elevation and Grade at Point Inquiry. I'll open that, click the Pick button, pick a point on a surface, and you can see it puts the arrow indicating the direction of the slope and also tells me the elevation and percent grade of the slope of that point. I can do a few other points as well, and each time it updates the information on the Inquiry tool.